We're going to kick off the Aztec Hour of the Huddle here on XTRA Sports 1360 with a guy that I've gotten to know very, very well the past couple years and look up to him and very, very respected man in his profession. And he was a very, very respected man when he played. Coach, Mr. Brian Sipe, how are you?
I'm doing great, Kevin. Those are kind words. I appreciate that. But it's great being on your show. Thanks for inviting me.
Yeah, no, I've wanted to have you on for a while throughout the whole season, but I know you've been busy having to coach up two separate quarterbacks and help coach this offense to a potential 10-win season.
Well, you're right. You know, sometimes it's great to be busy, and I feel like I'm in that spot right now, not only coaching, having had a chance to coach up Ryan Katz, who did such a great job for us coming in last spring and then getting us started this year and getting us on the right track, but then Adam Dingwell, watching him come to life, no surprise there. But all of that in the context of the great resurgence of San Diego State football. And I couldn't be a happier guy right now.
I want to talk to you about that, because when Coach Hoke brought you on to the staff, I think all the old school Aztec fans who remember your playing days, obviously, when you were playing for Coach Coriel, you guys were throwing the ball. It was a fun time on the Mesa and a tough ticket to get in town. And I know that's your ultimate goal as part of that staff now, to get it back to that. Do you guys feel like you're making progress? Because I certainly do.
Well, yeah, absolutely, Kevin. And I tell you, there's a lot of indicators. But one that I think all of us are noticing now is, on the staff, on the coaching staff, is the level of interest that we're getting from high school athletes right now. And it's ironic. In fact, here's another side note that would indicate the impact that we're having. We're having a lot of former Aztecs that chose to leave town to go play, where they thought greener pastures were, that are now inquiring about coming back and maybe finishing their career at San Diego State. There's improvement on all levels, but it looks to me like the future is bright now, Kevin. I mean, this is 3 years now of at least an 8-win season. We won 9 this year. We have a chance to win 10 games, and it's showing up. It's showing up everywhere we go.
I think the most impressive thing about the program and what you guys do on a daily basis is what no fans get to see. And being a former player, I get the luxury of being around the building quite a bit. And it's just the work. I mean, year-round, those kids and you guys are working to achieve the things that you want to achieve. It's not just talking about it and growing a program and bringing guys back to the program, but it's rolling up your sleeves with head strength coach Adam Hall in the summer, with you guys and Andy Ludwig on the field and training camp with Coach Long. It's the work that you guys do. Your practices are crisp. Everything that you guys do seems like it's the purpose and driving towards turning around that program and these wins that we've seen starting to pile up.
Well, I'm glad that you've noticed. I don't know. I couldn't put it more clearly than you just did. You know, this game is not for, certainly not for the faint-hearted, but it's also not for the half-steppers. You're either all in or you shouldn't be here. And Rocky makes that clear every single day. That's what I love about our kids. They know exactly what's expected of them. They know where we've set the bar, and they answer. And they get there early in the morning. Sometimes they're there at 5:30. They don't live the life that the rest of the college community lives, or even that most people think. These kids have a full-time job, and they go to school on top of that. And it isn't that school is the other thing that they do. We demand that they perform in the classroom as well. So it's a special group of guys. And I had the great fortune of having been invited to be on the staff by Brady Hoke, and now 2 years with Coach Long. It's the only experience that I have. I don't know what it's like at these other programs, but I can tell you it's an impressive thing that's happening at San Diego State right now.
Talking to San Diego State quarterback Coach Brian Sipe. Played at San Diego State from 69 to 71 before embarking on a 12-year NFL career with the Cleveland Browns. Every once in a while, I'll try to find some old tape of you running around making plays. He was the NFL MVP in 1980. You still, where's that trophy at right now?
Well, it's sitting proudly in my wife's office at home. You won't find the tape. I don't even think there was film back when.
Oh, come on.
I think they drew pictures of the game for the newspapers the next day. Yeah, I can hardly remember those times, but I do remember being wearing that red and black at San Diego State. And when the recruits come in, I always tell them, you know, you'd look good in red and black. We always thought we did. I don't think it's changed.
I want to ask you about Adam Dingwell. First of all, how's Ryan Katz doing? A quick update for everyone out there. He obviously is an Aztec for life, and we need to remember him for the solid seven games he put in for this program. How's he doing?
He's doing great. As a matter of fact, yesterday was the first day I saw him off crutches, walking in a walking boot, which is sort of a modern cast now. He's still several weeks out from getting that off. So he's got a slow recovery here. He had a bad break, and unfortunately, it was a bad break in a variety of ways. One was that he's going to miss an opportunity to play in a college All-Star game that he was slated to play in. He'll focus very hard on getting ready for his pro day when all the pro scouts come to San Diego State and the boys are the seniors, graduating seniors, are able to work out for them. He's going to work hard to do that, but Ryan wants to play some more football. He comes to our meetings. Of course he does, and we love him there. We love his input. He's prepared for the games mentally so that he stays sharp and has an opportunity maybe to impress some scouts later on. So we're very grateful for him, very grateful that he stayed around. He provided us with leadership, and he continues to do that even though he can't play.
I know every time I talk to Adam Dingwell, he mentions that leadership that he learned from Ryan Katz, and it took things from him here and there along the way. But I want to ask you about Adam. Obviously, he's undefeated as your team's quarterback. He's been able to make plays throughout the fourth quarter, clutch plays, and just seems to turn it up a notch. Is that something that you find in recruiting a guy, or is that something that you are pleasantly surprised with once he steps foot on campus?
Well, you know, it's something that we look for in all of our recruits. At the same time, I think we hold our breath. You want to see it, you think you see it, you look for it, but you never know until they get to this level and they see what is demanded of them. And we have an opportunity to see whether they're going to step up, whether they're going to take that next step to this level. Not many can, to be quite honest with you, particularly at the quarterback position. When you think that most programs take a quarterback a year, so there's usually five scholarship quarterbacks in a program, of those guys, only one of them gets to play, and he usually plays two or three years. So the attrition and the percentage of quarterbacks that actually succeed and do what they came there to do is relatively small. So Adam, I think that one thing we were always impressed with Adam, and we got it from his high school coaches, is that he's a competitor. He competed in high school. He wasn't only a quarterback. He played a variety of other positions. He was even the punter on the team. But we've also been impressed with his leadership. And that shows up in his rookie season when he's running the scout teams against the defense. I kept getting reports from Coach Hoke and Coach Long about this rookie quarterback and what a fighter he was and how feisty he was. And so I'm not surprised by anything that Adam is doing right now. He's exactly the kid we hoped he would be.
As far as Andy Ludwig goes, I think it's kind of been a little bit underrated as far as the games he called this year and the development of this offense and kind of how it's morphed into what it was with Ronnie and Ronnie Lindley there last year. And now all of a sudden you have Adam Wema, Walter Casey, these two quarterbacks, this physical presence. I think he's called a great game. What's it like to work with him on a weekly basis preparing for these football games?
Well, the man is a master at preparation and scheming. My learning curve has been real steep since he got there, and I've appreciated that. I think all of us, I talk about setting the bar high for the players. I think he sets the bar high for the offensive coaches and gives us a chance to respond. He listens to what we have to say, but he's a very accomplished guy. You know, this isn't the only place that he's had success. If you go back and look at his resume, it's very impressive, including that Sugar Bowl win against Alabama when he was the offensive coordinator at the University of Utah. So we're lucky to have Andy right now. And what I love about him is Rocky Long is a tough, hard-nosed, smash-mouth football coach, and we love that. But I'm talking as an alum. I love seeing this in our football team. Andy comes in. He's coached a whole variety of offenses, but he's got his finger right on exactly who we are as Aztecs right now. We're playing tough, downhill running football, and when he needs to, he mixes it up with play action passes and the big hits for scores. So I think everybody in San Diego should be grateful that we've got this guy.
How's the bowl prep coming?
It's going great. I think we're all kind of excited, Kevin, that we're getting closer to the game. the rookies have been getting a workout. We've had rookie scrimmages every night with those guys, and you kind of have to temper it a little bit. It's a whole month of work. That's one of the advantages of going to a bowl game. A lot of people don't understand that it's almost like another spring ball that we get a chance to develop the young players. But now it's time to kind of put our ears back and get serious about things. And I think everybody's excited to get started this week.
I think this team this year, it seemed like the head football coach's personality seemed to kind of trickle down to everybody involved in this program. Watching the team at Nevada kind of fight back and really have no quit, no kind of worry. It's just, let's go win this football game. Watching the team at Boise State, same thing. Going up there, a team that never loses at home, and you guys walk in there and you win that football game. Is it something that it's building wide across that whole facility, that everybody has kind of taken on Rocky's personality of being tough, being physical, and just not really making any excuses, just rolling up their sleeves and working?
That's certainly the case with the football program. You know, Steve Fisher has done just an unbelievable job with the basketball team. Mike Friesen had the girls' soccer as high as 7th in the nation this year. I mean, there's just so many good things that are happening right now. Girls' volleyball just won a Mountain West Conference championship. I think there's 9 conference championships now hanging at the facility. This is an unprecedented time at San Diego State. I'd like to think that football has an exaggerated impact on all of that. Certainly, you know, we play in front of a more television audience than the rest of the program, but I think it's a credit to Jim Sterk and what he's done with the entire department, all the coaching staff that's there on all of the different teams. And yes, there just seems to be a higher level of expectation now in Montezuma Mesa. And boy, if your listeners aren't Aztecs fans, they certainly, now's the time to tune in, because there's something special going on.
There's not too much room left on that bandwagon, Coach. We got to get everybody else involved in this town, no doubt about it. So BYU, what challenges do they present? What are you guys seeing on tape that might be a little bit of a struggle to handle?
Well, I tell you what, when I watch them, you know, I'm going to sound like a typical offensive coach, right? I'm going to make them sound like the greatest defense in the world, but truthfully, I don't know why that team isn't undefeated. And I know they've struggled some on offense. I know they've played freshman quarterbacks. I don't look at that side of the ball during preparation. It's all looking at the defense. But this is one of the top-rated rush defenses in the country. So I think one key for the fans that are going to tune into this game is that we've been so good on the run game, and that's where we start. You know, we're gonna hit you right in the mouth on play one, and if you don't have an answer for that, it's going to be a long night. And yet that seems to be the exact strength of this football team. They're a veteran defense. They really mix things up. They're smart, and they give you a whole lot of different looks. It's going to be a very interesting night. I don't know where it's all going to go, but I don't expect a high-scoring game, but it's going to be very physical.
Well, Coach, I appreciate you joining us. Obviously, anytime we can have anyone associated with the Aztec football team on, I know the listeners love it. You guys have had a heck of a season, and keep working. That 10th win will feel awful good, beating BYU at home on the 20th there on ESPN.
Well, no doubt. No doubt, Kevin. I appreciate you having me on. We go way back, Kevin. I remember when you played at La Costa Canyon. And it's great being on your program. I look forward to seeing you down there, too.
I sure wish I could have played for you. I mean, it was a couple years too early, but those guys are lucky to play for you, no doubt.
Yeah. Well, I appreciate that. Have a nice night.
You too. Thanks, Coach.